Hey, what's up, guys? Weekly Light here, and today I'm going to be covering the Pixie and Pit people. So, all Pixies, regardless of their armor, have a fire and explosive damage badge. They will have a 100% electricity weakness badge and a 50% fire resist badge. All the non-hero Pixies will have 3 movement steps, except for with the heavy helmet, and will have 3.5 hearts, which is about 60 health. The hero pixies will have 4 steps and 4 hearts, which is about 70 health. So first off, let's go over with the lightest helmet. I think it's like the no helmet. So with the no helmet, it has 90% weight, 2 range, 11 attack, and a high dodge chance, very high dodge chance. When it becomes the hero, its weight goes down to 65. It maintains 2 range, has an attack of 13, and still has a very high dodge chance. With the lightest helmet, the Pixie has 90% weight, 2 range, 11 attack, and a lower dodge chance. When it's the hero, it has 65% weight, 2 range, 12 attack, small amounts of defense, and a smaller dodge chance. When they get the medium helmets, the weight of the non-hero goes up to 100%, 2 range, 10 damage, a small amount of defense, and an even lower dodge chance. For the hero, it has 90% weight, 2 range, 11 attack, a medium amount of defense, and an okay-ish dodge. With the heaviest helmets, the non-hero becomes overweight and its movement speed goes down to 2. It has 2 range still, and its attack goes down to 8. It gains significant defense, but its dodge chance goes way down. When it becomes the hero, it doesn't get overweight, so it maintains its 4 steps. Its attack is 10, and it has pretty decent defenses, but still the very low dodge chance. All pixies have the option of what wings to have. The wings do not affect the stats and are purely cosmetic. Defensively, the Pixies are weak to electricity, so you want to keep them away from Electrobots or from the Shock Swords. They resist fire damage, so that means other Pixies and whatnot can't really hurt them, and also friendly fire from fire-based enemies also doesn't hurt it very much. The Pixies has an AoE attack that creates a big fireball. It's pretty inaccurate, but the middle of it will do the damage on your card based off of your helmet. So let's just say with my current helmet, it does like 12 or something. I'll do that plus or minus 2, right? And then the tiles around where it hits will do half of it. So anywhere from like if it's 12 plus or minus 2, it'll go to 6 plus or minus 1. This allows you to punish people for grouping up, and you can deal massive amounts of damage in a single turn. Pixies are very interesting because they have the potential to have one of the highest dodge chances in the entire game. If they have no helmet on, they will have an almost maxed out dodge bar, but with the heaviest helmet, they will have a very low dodge chance but higher defense. This can make it so sometimes your pixies will be like impossible to hit the entire game. They can also fly, so they're immune to snare. And they're also immune to spikes and floor hazards. Since their AoE attack is based off of fire and explosive damage, it means it's actually very good at taking out some of the bigger threats, such as the hair trolls or the troll moms. Especially the troll moms, because you can hit it on every single tile it stands on in one turn, effectively almost tripling your damage. In regards to choosing what armor you want on your Pixie, I would strongly recommend going with the no helmet option because it keeps your dodge chance the highest and also gives you the highest damage. Trading off damage and dodge chance for a small amount of defense doesn't seem correct to me, and I would much prefer to have the dodge chance because completely ignoring damage very often is better than always taking slightly less damage. You can build it however you want, but please don't make it not a hero with the heaviest helmet, because then you severely cut down its movement and it goes overweight and everything goes bad and it's not even worth running anymore. Currently, it fills the role of crowd control and really discourages enemies from grouping up. Enemies that group up will be easily taken out by pixies and punished. The fire damage left on the floor after the attack can still harm enemies and is very good at deterring enemies from traveling in places. Most importantly, it counters the hair troll, which is a very big threat in this game. So having a pixie pretty much makes it so that you can take their hair troll out early and you don't have to worry about its bothersome self-healing. So thank you for watching this video, and don't forget to check out the other ones and like, favorite, and subscribe. Thank you.